In this video, you will learn how to use the Postage Stamps Photoshop actions by PanosFX.com to turn any photo into a postage stamp or a collage which is made of different stamps. You will also learn how to create and add your custom postmarks to your stamps and how to create your own digital envelopes. Load the Postage Stamps actions in Photoshop's Actions panel. If the Actions panel is not visible, select Window, Actions, from the menu. Press the panel's menu button, and select Load, Actions, from the flyout menu. Navigate to the folder where you saved the Postage Stamps Actions file, and load it in Photoshop. The various Photoshop actions are grouped in three categories. The first category is called Solo Stamp, and contains three actions. Use them to turn a photo into a postage stamp of portrait, landscape, or square shape. The second category is called Create a Collage Made of Stamps. Use these actions to turn any photo into a collage made of different stamps. The third category is called Additional Actions. Use these actions to create your custom vector postmarks and your own envelopes. Let's run the first action. Select it, and hit the play button at the bottom of the panel. At this point, you can change the default size of the stamp photo to your preference. If you have the version for Photoshop Elements, you will be asked to insert the photo at this point. The Photoshop version of the actions makes use of smart objects. This powerful feature lets you edit dynamically the content of the stamp photo when the action completes. To insert the stamp photo, follow the text instructions on your screen. You can also go to the Layers panel and expand the group contents. Then double-click the thumbnail of the smart layer called Photo, or right-click on its name and select Edit Contents from the flyout menu. This opens a new Photoshop document, which contains the graphics of the stamp's photo. Let's add a photo. Select File, Place Embedded, from the menu. Load a photo from your hard disk. Resize it proportionally to cover the background. Nudge it to your taste, and double-click to insert it. You can add your custom text layers at this point, such as a short description, or the name of a country and the stamp's denomination. Press T to select the text tool, and add your custom layers. To update the stamp with your changes, simply save this document. You can make more changes. When you finish, close the document and save it to update the stamp. Now, let's see how we can tweak a few things, such as the frame color or the background. Select the frame layer, and double-click on the color overlay style, to edit the frame color. Let's change the background color. Double-click the background layer thumbnail, and pick a color of your choice. Let's change the background size. Select Image, Canvas Size from the menu. Enter the new size in pixels, and hit OK to confirm. You can also add a custom background image. With the background layer activated, select File, Place Embedded. I added a paper texture image in the background. Let's add some custom postmarks to make our image more interesting. Let's use the first round postmark action. You can edit the content of the three text layers. You can also change the font type and the font size to your liking. To confirm, hit the checkmark icon at the top of the screen, or hit the Enter key on your keyboard. The action will turn your custom postmark into a vector shape. You can change its size, and rotate it freely at any point, without losing on quality, because it's made of vector graphics. You can change the color of the postmark now. You can also change it later, by double-clicking its thumbnail. Let's make our image more interesting, by adding a wave postmark. Like the other postmarks, it's a vector shape. You can resize and transform it as many times as you wish. The actions in the second category will turn a photo into a collage made of stamps, which have the same or different shapes. Let's try the action that creates a collage made of 4 stamps, 2 landscape, and 2 square. The action will ask you to define the size of the collage. Enter your preferred size, while maintaining the width and height proportions. Then load a photo from your hard disk, and place it over the document. Resize it proportionally, to cover the red background. Use the mouse, or the arrow keys to nudge the photo to your liking, and double-click to confirm. The action created 2 different collages. In the second version, each stamp appears to be slightly detached from the others, and also has a drop shadow style applied. In this video, I'll move on, using this version. Each one of the 4 stamp photos is contained in its own smart layer, named Photo 1, Photo 2, Photo 3, and Photo 4 respectively. You can select any of these 4 smart layers, by right-clicking with the Move tool, on the respective stamp photo. Then you can edit the contents of the smart layer, by double-clicking its thumbnail, on the Layers panel. You can use the Text tool, to add your custom text to this stamp photo. To update the stamp photo, close this document and save your changes. Since the photo is a smart layer, you can open it again, make changes, and reapply them. Now I'll show you how to detach a stamp from the others. Press V to activate the Move tool, and right-click on a stamp. Then, select the photo layer from the flyout menu. Press Ctrl and T on a PC, or Command and T on a Mac, and detach the stamp. Double-click to confirm. Follow the same steps to detach more stamps. Now we will use one of the 2 envelope actions, to create a beautiful envelope, and place our collage on it. The action will ask you to define the size of the envelope. Enter your preferred size, and hit OK to confirm. In a second, the envelope is ready on your work area. Now let's find out how you can move the stamps collage onto the envelope. With the 2 documents arranged side by side, select the stamps group of layers, and drag it onto the envelope. resize and reposition the collage. I'll show you how to detach one stamp from the others. Press V to activate the Move tool, and right-click on a stamp. Then select the photo layer from the flyout menu. Press Ctrl and T on a PC, or Command and T on a Mac, and detach the stamp. Double-click to confirm. You can use the text tool to add your custom text above the envelope's four horizontal lines. I am using Adobe's handwriting font. Photoshop CC users can install it using their Creative Cloud desktop application. To customize the color of the edge marks, double-click the thumbnail of the blue marks or the red marks layer, and pick a color of your preference. Double-click the thumbnail of the lines layer to change the color of the horizontal lines. You can use the various postmark actions to add your custom postmarks to the envelope. Thank you for watching.